Tunisia is unique in North Africa. It's the only country that has transitioned to democracy after the Freedom and Dignity Revolution that started in December 2010. But Tunisia's progressive social and reproductive health policies create a false sense of gender equity and economic opportunity. Inequality in income and labor opportunities persists between regions and across gender. Women and young graduates are the most affected. Tunisia's high scores on various development indicators mask issues like high unemployment, corruption, and a system that benefits insiders as obstacles. Since the Freedom and Dignity Revolution, the economic situation has worsened and lack of reform of its subsidy policies have complicated the situation. The current political fragmentation, stagnant economy, and the impact of COVID-19 will test democracy in Tunisia. Tunisia's economy is stagnant because of its inefficient and bureaucratic government, low levels of investment, and the hurdles to participation in its small formal sector. Most people are forced to survive in a large low productivity informal sector. Import dependence on foodstuffs also exposes the country to international food price shocks. With declining foreign reserves, the country's food security situation will remain vulnerable. Yet, Tunisia has a well-educated and large working age population. Given employment opportunities, it should benefit from a demographic dividend, although its population is aging. A new report from the Institute for Security Studies uses the International Futures Modeling Platform to analyze the likely development trajectory of Tunisia to 2040 and compares it with the three alternative scenarios, exploring the impact and the trade-offs between these scenarios. Our analysis and forecast indicate that the government of Tunisia should first, reform its economy to allow greater inclusivity and competition. The most difficult of these reforms will be dismantling established interests and lowering the barriers of entry to participate in the formal economy. Second, create an environment conducive to small businesses and entrepreneurship to boost business and investments in the private sector and promote job creation and entrepreneurship. Third, continue with its efforts towards more targeted social safety net programs, such as the Universal Child Allowance Program, that would more effectively alleviate poverty and inequality and reduce subsidies that benefit the wealthy. Fourth, reform labor laws to allow the many qualified women and youth to participate in the labor market. Fifth, improve the quality of education and allow greater flexibility in the language of instructions. Sixth, take advantage of the potential to boost agriculture and improve food security. Finally, adapt to the impact of climate change through better management and the responsible use of water. Read the full report on the ISS website at www.issafrica.org.